Good morning, my wonderful, wonderful friends, wonderful family. I'd like to welcome you to today's broadcast. I am so sorry, Kalika. I was writing your name and the spell check kept, you know, throwing me off. So I wanted to welcome you. Thank you for being here. Angelica, welcome from Germany. Hello. Yes, we are a family here from all over the world. Let me know where you are watching from. I would love to know. It's such a blessing to have you here. And Gosha is here moderating. That's actually my husband, Mark. I'm so grateful for him. Tavi, welcome, brother. So good to have you here. We had the most beautiful spring day here in New Jersey today, right? It is just beyond belief. And it's just been a little bit on the cold side for the last couple weeks. So today it's like, ooh, yeah, break open the t-shirts, break open the windows wide open, and let in all of the sunshine. The music we have just heard is by Eric Satie, and it is his famous Gymnopédie in, which is the first one he wrote. And I play it because I have a couple of resources that I've been working on, some things that I hope would add value. One of them is, if you are playing piano, if you're a beginner, any level really, and interested in learning that piece I just played, dusting off maybe a piano or a keyboard instrument that's been lying around, and you need maybe some motivation to get back into playing or learn, I'm going to be starting next week a play-along for the first time. So what it is we will be learning this piece together in a community. We're going to be meeting once a week on Zoom. It's going to be a live interactive class. Each week I'm going to prepare the practice homework that you'll have and break down the piece so that you'll know how to practice it. And so we'll have 3 weeks of lessons and working our way through the piece. And then at the end, we'll have a piano playing party where you can play your version for the community, or if you would rather just listen and enjoy the music and just chat, that'll be great too. So it's something for, I think, all levels and all stages, and it'll be a lot of fun and something different and something new. And so I don't have the sign up ready yet. The link does not work. So if you try it below, don't be alarmed. That will be fixed. Please, Lord, help me fix that. And that'll be running next week. Also, we have on prayerpiano.com a new resource. And it's something, because people have been asking me recently, there seems to have been like a lot of people with trouble falling asleep. And I also went through that for months this year too, where just it's hard to fall asleep, or you wake up in the middle of the night, the mind is just like filled with thoughts. Seems to be a common issue. And music is such a soothing part of helping someone fall asleep. When you think about babies, lullabies, the sound of mama's voice, it's just that sweetness that lulls a baby to sleep. And so what I have done is I created it's called a sound sleep musical bath. And so as you get ready to fall asleep, can put that on. It's gentle music, and it has one of the sacred ancient frequencies as an overlay in back, which is a very soothing frequency, 417 hertz. And you'll read up more about that on the Prayer Piano website if that interests you. And so that also comes with a workbook, a little gratitude workbook. Why is that? part of it? Well, gratitude is the attitude for having a happy life. And that's the theme of today. How can we have a happier life? Gratitude is one of the highest frequencies we can have. When we are thankful, when we feel blessed, then right away it changes how we feel, it changes our attitude, it changes how people react to us, it changes our life. And so this workbook is just something to help you along. It's got some prompts, and we'll work through that together today a little bit as well, be part of our program. So what if, let's just talk about what if our attitude in life is the thing that changes our life more than any one thing, more than any circumstance, more than winning the lottery, more than anything else. You know, it's easy sometimes to stay stuck, right, in negative cycles. But today we're going to hear the story of composer Felix Mendelssohn. We started talking about Felix's grandfather, Moses, last week, and what an influential person he was, coming from the most unlikely background, right? And poor and not very strong physically, but yet a powerhouse who came into Germany, and he is known as the Martin Luther of Judaism. He was that revolutionary in changing the way people thought. And so today we'll talk about his grandson, Felix, and talk about how he was unlike many of the composers that we hear about. When we hear about composers, we hear a lot about, for instance, their struggles, Beethoven and his deafness, right? We hear a lot about Mozart being buried in a pauper's grave, Schubert, who was too poor to even afford a piano and who died at the age of 32. I mean, the stories of intense difficulty of the great composers is nothing new to us, but Felix Mendelssohn had quite a different kind of life. And his attitude towards life was also a reflection of the sun, the light, the goodness, the happiness that was in his heart. So we'll talk a little bit about that. Plus, we'll talk about the mysterious and wonderful cave in Scotland that Mendelssohn visited that made it really famous throughout the world and brought so many people to this cave. What was this cave like? What is so special and extraordinary about this cave that people called it the Cave of Melody? Okay, we'll also hear a piece of music that was inspired by Felix's travels. Okay, so why don't we get started right now with some gratitude. So if you have a piece of paper, pencil, if you've got your journal in front of you, great. If not, just you can do this exercise in your heart. And just let's reflect upon the three things that we are grateful for. Reflect on the things, let it come into remembrance. The three things that might have happened to you this week, and based on our last week's theme about breakthrough, just to refresh your memory, we were talking about breaking through, taking a chance, getting out of what is the usual, the ordinary, what is the expected way of being, and going in to something new, new territory. It may be taking a chance, breaking a routine in your life that you're so used to. starting something new, something fresh. It might be breaking through and also taking a risk, meeting someone in an uncomfortable situation. Maybe you've been estranged from somebody, and this week you had a chance to maybe reunite with them again, or talk to them, or be at least in the same space with them. You know, there are breakthroughs, there's seeds planted on every corner. So as we reflect about gratitude, I'm going to put up this wonderful scripture right now, and we can just, as we read this scripture, just with some, you know, music to help you reflect upon the gratitude in your heart. One thing I want to express gratitude and thanks of is my friend Delia. I'll tell you a little bit about something very special that is happening today that I will be attending after the broadcast. My friend Delia is from Romania. And I remember 4 years ago, she had a thought. And the thought was, oh, it'd be so nice to have a Romanian church in the area. There's no church that we have as Romanians to go to any place close. It was a thought. It was just an idea. And now here we are, 4 years later, and today, the most beautiful church. If you are on my Facebook, you will see pictures of this church. If not, I will try to share them next week. This most beautiful church today has its first, let's call it, grand opening. And it is glorious. It is spectacular. So much of it was built by the hands of the founding members of this church that put their whole heart and soul into this. And when I just think about, you know, I'm so blessed by my friend Delia, who, she's one of these types of people that it's not enough just to have the thought. No matter how far-fetched the thought may seem, she knows that it can be real. It can be realized, you know? And so when she said there needs to be a church, she really put her, you know, that saying, your money where your mouth is. I don't mean from a financial point of view, but like put action behind it and started doing it. So today we celebrate. The speaking voice went soft. Okay. Okay. Let me see if I can change the level. I am having some trouble with my equipment today, I have to say. Can you hear me? Can you hear me now? Is it okay? Back to normal, I hope. Is it okay? I'm going to take that as a yes. You never know with broadcasting. You just never know what could happen. Crazy things happen. Anyway, so that is what I am particularly grateful for. And so our theme today is be happy. Let's talk about sometimes we can rehearse, right? The same old story. We could rehearse the pain. We could like go through the bad things that have happened and feel sort of stuck in that get trapped, right? Today, let's get untrapped. And I'd like to
read from Philippians 4, 10 through 13. Okay, great. Thank you. Okay, now I rejoice greatly in the Lord that at last you have received your concern for me. You were indeed concerned, but you had no opportunity to show it. Let me just preface this by saying this is St. Paul writing. And basically, he's saying, you know, you guys, my friends, you've been worried about me. I see your concerns. I know that, you know, you've had some anxiety about it, but I'm okay. Okay, we resume the scripture now. He says, I am not saying this out of need, for I have learned to be content regardless of my circumstances. I know how to live humbly and I know how to abound. I am accustomed to any and every situation, from being filled and being hungry, having plenty or having need. I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. And I just think this is such a powerful reminder. It's not our circumstances, but it is, in fact, our faith, our hope that keeps us going. And Paul tells us this so plainly. He didn't see with his physical eyes his need or the reality, but he had already been living in his heart in another reality, which is incredible. Okay. So now let's just listen to a piece of music by Mendelssohn. I'm going to put the scripture back up so you can reflect on it a little bit as I prepare to play this piece. This is A Song Without Words in E major. So here we go.
All right, let's hear our beautiful Mendelssohn piece. Mendelssohn was born into a family that was wealthy. His father, Abraham, was a banker of the Mendelssohn Bank and actually funded Napoleon for a time. And their connections to the highest of society in Germany at the time brought in many opportunities for their children. Felix Mendelssohn had a sister named Fanny, and they were very, very close. Felix was a child prodigy, and so when we talk about child prodigies, it's always such a fascinating topic. However, Felix's level, by all accounts, for instance, the poet, writer, German famous Goethe said he had heard Mendelssohn and said this was like the same level as Mozart. So there's nothing small about this level of talent and brilliance. And so Felix decided to become a musician, which at first the family wasn't so crazy about, like most families. It's like, okay, can't you find something a little bit more stable to do? Can you enter the family business and banking maybe? But no, his talent was just so incredible, as was his sister Fanny's. In fact, Fanny was so prodigious in music as well. A lot of times there is also speculation what was written by Fanny that we think is written by Felix, you know? So that was, they shared a closeness that was so loving and beautiful. Felix had such a wonderful way of interacting with people too. He always made them feel like they were first. He never showed off that he was, you know, from such a big aristocratic family. He never showed off his talent in a way that wasn't humble. He was a person that had great faith, and somehow he was able to he was converted to Christianity, and he was yet faithful to his Hebrew roots. So he was very much this in between the two great traditions, and his music reflects his love of the Bible. He wrote an oratorio named Elijah that is just absolutely incredible. Talking about worship music, if that is not a worship piece, I don't know what is. So very much recommended to listen to. It is just so great for igniting the faith. Felix married, and he had a wonderful marriage with a great beauty of the time named Cecile. And so they also had children and just a very, very happy life. And Mendelssohn loved traveling. In fact, at one time he went to Italy, and the famous Italian symphony was written there. As well, he went to Scotland and saw a mysterious cave there. And this mysterious cave gave him the inspiration for writing music. He came back, and in his letters and to all his correspondence with people, he would talk about this incredible cave where he heard this incredible music inside this cave. It's a wonder of the world. It's called Fingal's Cave. And I was on YouTube, and I said, I wonder if there's any accounts of anybody swimming in this cave and could show us a little bit what it looks like. And yep, I found somebody who went swimming with a GoPro, and they filmed the experience in the cave. So how about we take a look at Fingal's Cave? Now, here we go.
That looks good, actually. No guarantees. I tested. Testing the swell before I get in. Right. Now then. Ooh, that's not too bad. All right.
that's good. Yeah, that's good. Well, I'm just hoping this camera's working. Very pink in here.
Okay, so that's really quite a remarkable sight, the way that this cave is formed. And I wish he had gone even deeper, like inside, to give us a sense of it. But even just what, you know, the pinkish hue of those rocks and just that blue water, how incredible this is. So then Mendelssohn wrote a piece on this cave called Fingal's Cave. It's Overture of the Hebrides, or Hebrides. I don't think I'm saying it correctly, but in any case, you can look it up. It is Fingal's Cave. Now, I have to just tell you, this piece that we're going to listen to a portion of, this is Mendelssohn's Fingal's Cave. This has happened to me more than once. The first time I thought it was a fluke, and I'll tell you what it was. This was a few years ago. I was driving and I had like the worst migraine headache. It was just so bad. And I didn't have any like Advil or anything, because it was like one of those Advil kind of headaches where only Advil will help. And I put this music on, and literally there was something about the way Mendelssohn recreates these waves in the sound. I don't know what happened, but like the waves of these music hit the waves of this headache, and it just like neutralized it. It was the most powerful thing. And I thought, okay, that was a fluke. Maybe it was just like a one-off thing. The next time I got a headache, I said, let me see if this will help again. And I did, I played it again, and again, it took care of the headache. So I'm kind of confident that this is a cure for headaches, common headaches. Okay, so just an aside, and let's listen to a bit of Mendelssohn's masterpiece, the Fingal's Cave Overture. Okay, such beautiful music. That's just only a small portion of it. I got a slap on the wrist for using YouTube videos on my live stream. Apparently there's like copyright stuff, so I can't use too much of it, but I just wanted to have you hear it because it is not one of the more common known pieces of Mendelssohn, but I think just absolutely a stunning piece. Did you hear the waves? Did you hear like that just scintillating sound? It's just unbelievable. Unbelievable. So now we're going to turn our thoughts into prayer and petition, because this is Prayer Piano and we are a community here, and we give thanks, we give gratitude, we give worship, we do it through our community, through our hearts, through our shared song, through using the great music of these wonderful composers who were faithful people and whose music really was a form of worship. But we also have our own particular prayers and petitions. And we have seen in this community powerful, powerful breakthroughs and the power of praying in this community. So right now, I would like to offer an opportunity for anybody, you know, this candle shall be our cue for that. Anybody who has any particular prayer requests. Yeah, that was the one, Tabi. That was the one. Yes. So yeah, that's the overture from the Hebrides by Mendelssohn, or the Fingal Cave overture, either one. Okay. So now we'll have a moment to kind of lift up our praise and prayer request. If there are any particular situations that you would like prayer for, you don't have to be, you don't have to give too much information away. If you just want to put one word in the chat, just one word to describe the petition for which we will pray for, feel free to do that. I would like to invite you now to listen to, as we pray, as we give our thanks, to a Venetian boat song, another piece inspired by Mendelssohn's trips abroad. And I'd like to set that also with a scripture from Isaiah 61:3, to bestow on them a crown of beauty instead of ashes, the oil of joy instead of mourning, and a garment of praise instead of a spirit of despair. They will be called oaks of righteousness, a planting of the Lord for the display of his splendor. So you are a planting like the oak tree. Thank you, sister. It's such a powerful and so peaceful. Exactly, exactly. We are to be these oaks of righteousness, the planting of the Lord for the display of his splendor. So you are a display of his splendor. Wherever you go, you have that splendor around you. But like the scripture reminds us, we have to first give our ashes, our sorrow, our sadness, our disappointments. Those are our ashes, in order to claim the beauty. So it is just such a powerful reminder. Also, the power of laughter. Did you know that there was a man who was critically ill and the doctor said, well, you've got like only about 4 months left to live. So, you know, just, you know, good luck. And he went home and he started to watch funny movies, just like old fashioned comedies, I Love Lucy and all that stuff. He just was laughing all the time. And do you know, that laughter was the best medicine. It's not a joke. Laughter was the best medicine. This guy recovered. So the power of being happy, the power of having a cheerful heart like Mendelssohn had. He had a cheerful heart. Yes, he happened to have a life that was more pampered than other composers had, but he had a cheerful heart. Was it his circumstances, like Paul was saying? It's not about circumstances. I've got a cheerful heart, even though people are after me, even though I'm being sought after, attacked, hunted down. Paul said, I rejoice. I say rejoice. And at that time where he said those words, he was actually dunked into a pool of excrement. Okay, but he was saying, rejoice, I say rejoice. Now that's an extreme example of not letting the circumstances dictate your joy. Laughter, Proverbs 17:22 reminds us, a cheerful heart is good medicine, but a crushed spirit dries up the bones. So as we listen today to this Venetian boat song of Mendelssohn, let us be reminded of the joy that is our birthright as believers. Let us be reminded of the miracle of life around us, and let us grab hold of the gratitude that no matter what circumstances or what might be going wrong, can you find something good in it? Can you find something to be thankful for? There's always something to be thankful for. And so we could flip the script, and we could flip our reaction, our feeling towards it, and quite possibly our outcome. So as we listen to the Venetian boat song, I just pray for whatever petitions are on your heart. And yeah, is that amazing? Yeah, right? Cheerful heart. God's timing is so good. Prayers for my new home. Yes, sister, that is on the list. Also, I want to mention, Tabi, praying for this wonderful new opportunity in your life. Tabi shared it with me. I'm just so excited for you. That proverb, yes, cheerful heart is good medicine, but a crushed spirit dries up the bones. Okay, so for the intentions here mentioned, Lord, we just lift them up. Lord, you know the needs of our heart. Lord, we praise you. We give you alone the honor, Lord, and the praise and the worship, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for the reminder of joy, that joy is our birthright, that a cheerful heart is good medicine, Lord. Help us to see and feel your joy in every situation, Lord. Help us to listen with new ears this week. Help us to be lifted up in joyous sound, in joyous praise, even as your beautiful seasons change, Lord, and we hear the beautiful sound of the birds outside singing your songs of glory and praise, Lord. Let us also be reflections of that glory and praise wherever we go. We ask this in the name of Christ Jesus. Amen. Okay, so let's now listen to this again, water music of Mendelssohn, the Venetian boat song. Thank you. my wonderful family, God bless you all. Stay tuned for next week. We will continue, most likely, our final installment on Mendelssohn and the powerful Bach connection. This is a story that if you've ever watched shows like American Pickers or those shows like where people buy something for like $5 at a garage sale thinking it's just, you know, what, like a average painting, and then they take it to be appraised and it turns out to be a lost masterwork of like Rubens or something and worth like $10 million. Well, this will be that kind of a story, just to like whet your appetite for it. Okay, so stay tuned next week. If you have any petitions that you'd like to share, any things that you would like to lift up, please feel free to just contact me through email. The email's on prayerpiano.com. And until then, I wish you all, praying Lord's blessing upon you, about all your comings and goings. May they be blessed. May you be surrounded and protected with God's love, light, his ministering angels. May you be filled with joy. May the light enter any places of worry and despair, and reminding us all today that in order for us to have this crown of beauty, the crown that Isaiah 61:3 speaks of, we have to hand over our ashes. So we are just praying, Lord, that any ashes that are still within us, any kind of areas that we still are struggling with, Lord, that we need your hope to breathe new life, your Ruah spirit into, Lord, we just pray for that to happen. And we just give you alone the praise and glory. And this week, guys, let's laugh more. Let's watch some funny movies. And, I love what you said, John. We open our heart and open our arms, and we will elevate our attitude. That's right. It's through openness. Okay, I'm going to make it a point this week to watch a funny movie. And I will report back next week, because I feel inspired by the cheerful heart. Let's have some fun this week. Let's have some more laughs this week, everybody. I think we need it. And we'll report back next week. Okay, I want to hear if you watch any funny movies, if you do anything really fun. Let's share. Let's get some ideas shared in our community and inspire one another. I thank you all. Be blessed, be happy, be healthy, and see you next week.